Hey guys, I am making some essential oils, and so I thought I'd make a video of that. I put it off as long as I can. I'm running low. Let me see, where'd I put that bottle? Excuse my messy kitchen. Oh, here it is. This nighttime leg calm. I order it, but what's funny is, even on sale, it's like 15 bucks. And the main ingredient's lavender. Why the hell am I paying for it when I have lavender that I grow? So, I got a saucepan, and I got some oil in it, and I cold pressed this first, but it wasn't getting strong enough, so I'm hot pressing it now. Right now I have rosemary and lavender in there, and I have some comfrey. I need to add more lavender to it. And more comfrey, and I'll probably add a little bit more water to it. And then I have my homemade granola cooking. It has about 10 minutes left. And what I do, ignore my crock pot, I'm still waiting for the chicken to thaw out here. But I order a lot of my stuff in big old bags like this on Etsy, or Etsy, however you say it. Here's my comfrey. I have fresh comfrey. But this dried stuff I need to use up first because it's older. A lot of these are teas too. Like I'll mix, this is a cough medicine tea. This is a red robos where I put vanilla in. It's so good. And then there's a pain and sleep tea that my kids use. And this is a calming tea with mugwort. It's really, really good. Mint. I wonder if I should put some mint in this press I'm making. Part of the reason that I don't give people my recipes is because I go by what I have at the time. So like I make an ointment that everybody seems to love, but I don't have a recipe down. I used to use a medicated Vaseline. If anybody knows where I can get that, let me know, because I don't make it anymore. And then I would put comfrey in there. I do it like the oil, but I would melt the Vaseline down. And this is on your lowest temperature. And then I add my herbs to it until I feel like it's strong enough. And I may leave a little herb in there. And then you use it for your lips, and you use it for... My daughter gets that winter rash thing around here and on her hands. Oh, this is some of my homemade wine I use for cooking too. Okay, I made this video because my 10-year-old goes around telling people I'm a witch, but she means it in the nicest way because I make these ointments. See, I mean, my whole kitchen's a mess, but... See, I have little bottles like this of stuff and then bigger bottles of what I make. And then I have the dried herbs everywhere. And then my medicine cabinet. See, I have some real medicines in there, but this is for earache, and this is olive oil that I soaked garlic in it. And you won't have to, if your kids start getting earache and you do that, and if they're old enough to take Benadryl, you won't have to put them on antibiotics. But I better go so I can get some more lavender put in here. I'm out of breath. Alright, just thought I'd share this with you. You let this like simmer. You can do it in a double boiler and put this in the top. But, and the book says 3 hours. I play it by ear since I don't use the double boiler method until I get the right strength. And I'm not smelling enough lavender in it. And I've had to use, the oil I've had to use isn't the extra virgin. I'm not crazy about this. This isn't my first choice, but it's an olive oil blend. Not my first choice, but being that I have hardly any money, I gotta do what I gotta do. Alright, maybe I'll get this kitchen cleaned up a bit. I got barbecue chicken legs gonna be cooking in the crock pot. I'm working on that. And then I got rolls rising here. Got some dishes done, but so that's why I say I think I'm getting over whatever this is. Alright, well, talk to you guys later. See ya.